given by the scientific committee, organizing committee. So now I'm sharing my slide and coming to my topic, that is tuberculosis and diabetes mellitus made for each other. So of course, the next.
Yeah, good.
You see, this is the first slide, and if you see, there is no tuberculosis. There are two prime ministers. Why I have come with first slide with two prime ministers? Because tuberculosis has been a concern from era of Nehru to Modi. Why I'm saying, because the wife of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the first prime minister of divided India, I would say, because I feel that the first prime minister of undivided India was different. He was Subhash Chandra Bose. And us, yes, you can record my words, no problem. Yes, I believe, and now within 5 years, most of us will believe like this. The first prime minister of India, the undivided India, was the Subhash Chandra Bose. And the first prime minister of divided India is Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. What he wrote about the tuberculosis, whether we ourselves have escaped from the scourge of tuberculosis or not, there is probably hardly a family which has not had to do something with this dreaded disease. So these were the words written by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the first prime minister of divided India. And he was forced to write these lines about tuberculosis, because this was not a political issue for him. This was not a partition issue of India for him. This was a very emotional issue for him, because his wife, Kamala Nehru, died of tuberculosis. And now coming to the current prime minister, the Narendra Modi, and I still remember the day, the 13th March, 2018. Yes, I'm talking of NTB by 2025, that is Delhi and TB summit, which was held in the presence of Director General of WHO. You can see the photograph of that time. Luckily, I was present in that meeting in Delhi and summit on 13th March, 2018, when Prime Minister Modi declared the very auspicious target of ending TB by 2025, which is 5 years ahead of the WHO target. So now, after this, I'm coming to directly to the Global Tuberculosis Report 2021. Which says I'm coming to the NTB strategy at a glance. So this is the NTB strategy at a glance, and you can see here that is the vision is the world free of TB, zero deaths, disease, and suffering due to TB. Everything should be zero when we talk of the NTB strategy globally. Goal is end the global TB epidemic, and indicators are. So three types of indicators, and the milestone have been set by 2020, already gone, 2025, 2030, and 2035. So this is basically the last target is at the 2035. But our Prime Minister has said that we have to meet the target of NTB strategy of 2030 by 2025 in India. So I will not go into the detail, but I will just say that the target fixed by globally by 2020 in the process of NTB strategy were very, of course, encouraging. But however, these targets cannot be achieved. The target of TB incidence rate was 20% reduction by 2020. However, there was only 11% reduction from 2015 to 2020. The number of TB death target was the 35%, but this could be done only by 9.2%. The target of suffering the facing catastrophic cost means the financial problem faced by the TB patient, this should be zero by 2020, but even 47% people is still facing this catastrophic cost. So the target could not be achieved internationally even then. Now, after the declaration of Prime Minister's NTB by 2025, the whole scenario was changed. The revised National Tuberculosis Program, which was the earlier name, was changed to National Tuberculosis Elimination Program from January 2020. And key activities were decided. And key activities, there was a plan. This is called National Strategic Plan for Tuberculosis Elimination from 2020 to 2025. But unfortunately, the 20 and 21 have gone, of course, due to COVID. The target could not be achieved. So even then, we are struggling to, of course, declare NTB by 2025. Now, this is the global and Indian scenario. the global share of the tuberculosis by India is 27%, means every fifth TB patient is Indian. Mortality of TB, if you see, 31% share from in India, as far as the global, of course, mortality scenario is concerned. And if you see the multi-drug resistant TB burden, this is also 24%. And children with TB suffering is also 31%. Now, coming to the very important link for which I have been given the topic, diabetes and tuberculosis. This is the Sustainable Development Goal number 3. There are 17 SDG goals. And out of these 17 goals, there is a goal number 3 that says reduce premature mortality due to the non-communicable diseases. And out of the all NCDs, the important alternative indicator have been decided as prevalence of diabetes. And the rationale behind this is that diabetes is a strong risk factor for development of TB disease, although a link with the TB incidence at the national level has been difficult to establish. So this is my topic from Sustainable Development Goal, probably Anuj Maheshwari, Dr. Narasimha Verma has brought. So this is the, I'm saying India was doing fairly well from declaration of Prime Minister Modi and TB by 2035. But in COVID-19, there is a lot of speculation that all national health programs suffered, including the tuberculosis. But the time will tell, because still we are in phase of analyzing the data. So we don't know whether due to lockdown or due to, of course, use of masks, we have decreased TB communication or we have increased, we have neglected TB. This time will tell. So this debate is going on. But still the scenario is that India is the highest TB burden country with 27% of the global share. Now, coming to the diabetes, everything you know better than me, so I'm not waste my any time. You know better, this is the projection for 2040, around 642 million diabetes cases in India. And of course, now I will discuss the two very important aspect. You said my topic is diabetes, mellitus, and tuberculosis made for each other. So how made for each other? What is the impact of diabetes on tuberculosis, and what is the impact of tuberculosis on diabetes? Now, first, I will come to impact of diabetes on tuberculosis. So we know there is a concept called latent tuberculosis infection and active tuberculosis. And it is said that diabetes increases the risk for progression from latent TB infection to active TB disease and complicates treatment of active TB. How we will go? This is a very important data that shows diabetes as a predisposing factor for. So diabetic patients are more susceptible for urinary tract infection by 28.6%, tuberculosis in 20%, skin and soft tissue infection in 14%, bacterial pneumonia in 10%, and although some rare, of course, additional risk factor for foot infection also. So our concern is tuberculosis, means 20% additional risk means almost 5 times more risk for developing tuberculosis in diabetics. So let us discuss how this 4 to 5 times more risk. So impact is that TB occur with an increased frequency in diabetics. Increased frequency is due to reactivation of old focus. In very interesting data is that this is most of the time due to reactivation, not because of reinfection. Reactivation of old focus means at the age of 5 years, suppose somebody got infection of tuberculosis and Gons focus or healed focus form. At the age of 40 years, he developed diabetes. Diabetes is uncontrolled. And at the age of 43, he developed reactivation of that old primary focus, which he acquired at the age of 5 years. So this is called reactivation of old focus. And this is the usual story of all diabetics. They are developing diabetes, uncontrolled, remain uncontrolled, and their old focus remain activated, become activated. So diabetes is also independent risk factor, not only tuberculosis, for developing lower respiratory tract infection. So even pneumonia, LRTI. So if patient is having COPD with diabetes, then of course he is bound to have more lower respiratory tract infection during the change of season and winter season because of this, of course, strategy, this, of course, concept. Now, a lot of studies have been done. I'm not going into the detail of studies because in a short 20 minutes time, you cannot go with the detailed study. But then this 1990, the Tanzania study shows that there is a 9% of tuberculosis prevalence in comparison to the 2.7 in non-diabetics. So the frequency is 4 to 5 times. Again, the similar kind of study, some study shows 10 times raise, some say 14.8 point raise. And there are some basis why diabetics develop more pulmonary tuberculosis. There are anatomical factors. What anatomical factors? Which leads to the increased susceptibility? The increased thickened alveolar epithelial and pulmonary capillary basal lamina is the one anatomical change due to diabetes, and microembolization of pulmonary artery. This is the second anatomical change, which makes vulnerable, more vulnerable for the tuberculosis, some degree of centrilobular emphysema. And we have already described all these changes in our publication. And luckily this publication is Dr. Narsingh Verma. The physiological factors responsible for the increased susceptibility, yes, increased systemic inflammation, reduction in antioxidant defense mechanism, and increased thickening of alveolar capillary and arterial walls are the physiological changes which are making a diabetics more susceptible for pulmonary tuberculosis. There are certain nutritional and biochemical factors responsible for increased susceptibility. The hyperglycemia favors growth, viability, and propagation of tubercular bacilli. Disturbance in electrolyte balance and local tissue favor infection, and disturbed nutritional balance are some other factors. Still, there are some other factors. Immunological factor responsible for increased susceptibility for pulmonary tuberculosis are the abnormal chemotaxis, adherence, phagocytosis, and microbial function of the formal polymorphonuclear cells, decreased peripheral monocyte with impaired phagocytosis, decreased C3 opsonin function, inadequate cell-mediated immunity. These are the all factors. आधे से ज़्यादा मुझे भी नहीं समझ में आए, लेकिन बोलना था तो इसलिए मैंने बोल दिया. नरसिंह वर्मा बाद में समझा देंगे आपको. So what is the impact of diabetes on sputum conversion? Very important. Very interestingly, there are a lot of studies which show that the sputum smear and culture conversion are indicators for infectivity of TB patient. And means, hum ARB positive patient ko TB ki dawa dete hain aur kab uska sputum negative ho jata hai, isko hum log kehte hain sputum conversion. So tuberculosis diabetic patient have a higher pre-treatment bacillary load. Ye dekha gaya hai ki bacterial population diabetics mein bahut jyada. Arre bhai, khane ko chini mil rahi hai aur kya chahiye? जहां भंडारा लगाओ वहां भीड़ तो लगेगी. सो ऑल ट्यूबरक्यूलर बेसलाई दे फ्लरिश वेरी वेल इन दी शुगर मीडिया, एंड दैट्स व्हाई दी ट्यूबरक्यूलोसिस पेशेंट हु डेवलप ट्यूबरक्यूलोसिस, दी डायबिटिक पेशेंट हु डेवलप ट्यूबरक्यूलोसिस, दे हैव हायर प्री ट्रीटमेंट बेसलरी लोड, एंड अनकंट्रोल्ड डायबिटीज कैन लीड टू डिले इन स्पुटम कन्वर्जन, देयर वाई इंक्रीजिंग दी चांसेस ऑफ developing resistance tuberculosis. That's why drug resistance also are relatively high, although some contradictory studies are available which are denying this. But anyway, one thing is clear, that to begin with, bacillary load is high, and that's why to kill these bacilli you require moderation of anti-tubercular treatment, and that's why especially when diabetes is uncontrolled. Relapse. So how, if you treat completely and patient has been declared, of course, cured, and the patient is now having controlled diabetes, then there is no additional risk of a relapse. But if the diabetes remain uncontrolled further, then of course, the chances of relapse also more. So this is the source. Is there any additional, as such, due to the drug resistance, there is no additional risk of drug resistance due to diabetes. But only thing is, if the duration of high bacillary load is there, so more chances of mutation. If the more mutation, then more chances for drug resistance. That is the theory behind the more chances. Even so, still, but this theory is not proven. So the relationship between the diabetes and MDR-TB remains unproven. Still, we need a lot of studies to be done. Now, second aspect of my talk is, what is the impact of tuberculosis on diabetes? So now coming to the another aspect of the coin. So what is the impact? This study published in 2014 showed that the burden of diabetes in TB patient is high, and that is feasible to carry out a screening for diabetes as a routine test for persons with diabetes. Har TB ke mareej ki screening honi chahiye, ye inhone kaha, aur ye niyam ban chuka hai ab. 2016 में एक स्टडी होती है, वो भी इंडिया में होती है, दैट इज ऑल्सो सेइंग द सेम थिंग. एंड 2017 ऑल्सो 18 स्टडी, बोथ इंटरनेशनल स्टडी, दे आर ऑल्सो सेइंग सेम थिंग. एंड ऑफकोर्स महमूद स्टडी, दिस इज ऑल्सो सेइंग द सेम थिंग. एंड द पांडे एट ऑल स्टडी फ्रॉम मणिपाल अकेडमी ऑफ हायर एजुकेशन, दिस इज ऑल्सो सेइंग दैट यस, देयर इज अ ओवरऑल प्रेवलेंस ऑफ डायबिटीज इन टीबी पेशेंट वॉज 25%, वेरी हाई. So from 10 to 25% of tuberculosis patients, they can have diabetes. What is the impact? Clinical and subclinical hypoadrenalism causing decreased stress response. This is responsible for the of course, increased chances of diabetes. So even the latent diabetes can manifest during the tuberculosis. Decrease in endocrine function of pancreas with increased pancreatic calcification is one factor. Fatty acid transporter proteins in the tubercular bacillus may cause dysregulation of energy homeostasis in the disease, such as hepatic glucose metabolism. Now, coming to the, are clinical features different? No. The clinical features are same. The fever, productive cough, anorexia, loss of weight, hemoptysis, chest pain. Same type of clinical features. There is no difference. Then, of course, even the only thing is that low-grade fever and productive cough are the most common symptom and chances of hemoptysis are higher. So that is the only difference, and which, of course, have been mentioned in our article, that yes, the chances of the rate of hemoptysis is higher than non-diabetics. The only difference in clinical presentation. Diagnosis, is there a different tool required for the diagnosis of diabetics with pulmonary tuberculosis? No. Same kind of tools required, same approach, same algorithm. This algorithm is available on the Central TB Division website of Ministry of Health and Family Welfare of Government of India. I will not go into the detail. In nutshell, I would say the three things are required for the diagnosis of pulmonary tuberculosis. Number one is sputum smear examination for AFB, that is old. Old is gold. Second is the CVNet or TrueNet. And third is the chest X-ray. So now three tools, sputum for AFB, sputum for CVNet or TrueNet, that is molecular test, and chest X-ray PU. So remember three tools for the diagnosis of pulmonary tuberculosis in non-diabetics also and in diabetic also. And similar algorithm, same kind of algorithm for extrapulmonary tuberculosis. For extrapulmonary tuberculosis, take the sample, process for the CVNet, process for the smear, and you take the help of CT scan, ultrasound, MRI, biopsy, FNAC, some other procedures. And this is the integrated drug resistance TB diagnostic algorithm for the drug resistance TB. And I will request everybody, if you are, of course, suspecting drug resistance TB, so please refer. In Uttar Pradesh, we have 22 nodal DRTB center, and every district is having district TB center, district TB center for the resistant TB. So in India, all the districts have the facility for the diagnosis and treatment of drug resistance TB. We have more than 641, more than 1100 now CVNet machines throughout the country. So even some districts have more than 2, 3, 4 CVNet machines. So there is no paucity of any diagnostic tool throughout the country. And better you refer the program to the refer the patient to the program. This would be better because all investigation are free, treatment is free, and tuberculosis, your tuberculosis patient will get 500 per month nutritional program as per the, of course, guidelines issued by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare under the instruction of Prime Minister Modi. And if you are a private practitioner, you will get incentive also. So that is wonderful thing, which I have, of course, brought for you also. So that's why you require screening for diabetes mellitus in persons with active TB. So all active TB patients should be screened for. This has become now rule. And screening of diabetes, you know better than me. So abnormal glucose value should be verified with a repeat test if person has no symptom of diabetes. So that is a clinical decision, your physician decision that you can. And you know better criteria, HbA1c, fasting glucose, 2 hours plasma glucose, random glucose. So every criteria you know better than me. And of course, so your diagnostic work of with diabetes and tuberculosis can be done by medical history, physical examination. Tuberculin test is still reliable. Yes. Sputum microscopy and culture, chest radiography, CT scan of thorax, optional. Whenever you require, bronchoscopy is optional. Whenever you require, and molecular techniques is essential. Now, I would focus on the emphasis of sputum microscopy. Sputum microscopy, now we have, of course, changed the AFB with fluorescent microscope. Now, there is no Jean Nelson staining. There is a fluorescent microscope. Every dot center in India now is having this latest fluorescent microscopy with high specificity and sensitivity. And microscopy is more objective and reliable than X-rays. So please don't over rely on the chest X-ray. Always rely more on the sputum examination. And of course, you can have the sputum culture, although that is the solid culture for acid fast bacilli, or rapid culture, that is liquid culture. All tertiary care centers in India, including King George Medical University, they are having facility for the rapid culture. So Now coming to the radiology. Radiology is always suggestive. It is never diagnostic. The only difference is the, usually pulmonary tuberculosis have upper zone involvement, but some atypical features may be in diabetic. That is, lower zone involvement is relatively more than non-diabetics. So the lower involvement of lower lung field lesion among diabetics is 19% against the 7% in non-diabetics. So overall, upper lobe presentation is still common in diabetic, but in comparison to the non-diabetics, there is a 2.5 times more chances for involvement of lower lobe. So this is the chest X-ray, and whenever you have a shadow like this in lower zone, always suspect that the patient has having pulmonary tuberculosis with diabetes. Now, X-ray-based evaluation. Now, those who are more in favor of X-ray, this is my folded hand request, that X-ray leads to over-diagnosis. So there is always diagnosed by X-ray alone, there is over-diagnosis. So don't rely on X-ray too much. X-ray is suggestive, never diagnostic. And main to aksar kehta hun ladkon ko padhate samay ki bhai wo zamane gaye jab ladka ladki pe ek dusre ke photo dekh ke shaadi kar lete the. Ab nahi hai. अब तो मीटिंग डेटिंग पता नहीं क्या क्या होता है, तब डायग्नोसिस बनती है शादी की. तो इसी तरह एक्सरे पे उतना रिलाई मत करिए. एक्सरे इज अ फोटोग्राफ ऑफ द लंग. इसीलिए मैं 1996 से कह रहा हूं कि जैसे हर चमकती चीज सोना नहीं होती, वैसे ही हर एक्सरे का धब्बा टीवी नहीं होती. तो इसको याद रखिए. एंड यू कैन यूटिलाइज द चेस्ट सीटी स्कैन, ऑफकोर्स मॉलिक्यूलर डायग्नोसिस, दैट इज पॉलीमर चेन रिएक्शन, एंड ऑफकोर्स सीबी नेट, ट्रू नेट, एवरी मशीन इज अवेलेबल. Differential diagnosis you have to keep. That heel pulmonary tuberculosis can be wonderful. Of course, differential diagnosis, lung cancer, interstitial lung disease, bronchiectasis, COPD, tropical pneumophila, lung abscess, pneumonia, chronic eosinophilic lung disease, congenital pulmonary of course, abnormalities can all be the differential diagnosis. For treatment, you require correct categorization, and for that you require whether you are dealing with pulmonary tuberculosis or extrapulmonary, either AFB positive, AFB negative, rifampicin sensitive or rifampicin resistant, on the basis of CBNet or TrueNet, previous history of treatment, diabetes, HIV status, and body weight of the patient. Must remember. And treatment strategy for tuberculosis and diabetes are no different than tuberculosis. So treatment remain the same. Strategy remain the same. So you will screen for the patient of tuberculosis for sugar also if you are not screened. And if there is a symptom of tuberculosis in diabetic, then you will. Success of the TB treatment are the four C's. First C is for correct diagnosis. Second C for correct characterization, whether it is sensitive TB or resistant TB. There are only two categories now, sensitive TB or drug resistance TB. In drug resistance TB, monodrug resistance, polydrug resistance, or multidrug resistance, or extensive drug resistance. Correct prescription, compliance to the treatment. So these are the body weight. This is again available on weight. So take the weight of the patient, and according to the body weight band, you prescribe the various FDC, which is available in the program. Even if you can prescribe the non-program, yes, you can prescribe directly, but notification is mandatory. So do notification on the NICHE portal. So computerized notification is now mandatory. So went for children, and this is the new classification of the various drugs for treating of the multi-drug resistant tuberculosis. I will not teach more because this is, I would like that please refer to patient to the program so that patient can, because these are the costly drugs, so that patient can, पेशेंट को फ्री दवा मिल जाए, 500 रुपया महीना मिल जाए, आपको इंसेंटिव मिल जाए और उसके साथ साथ मरीज की दुआ मिल जाए. तो इसलिए प्रोग्राम को रेफर कर दीजिए. और ये ग्रुप ए, ग्रुप बी, ग्रुप सी में किस तरह से हम सेकेंड लाइन ड्रग चूज करते हैं, उसकी एक स्ट्रेटजी है, वो मत जानिए, ये उसकी डोजेज है. एंड मैनेजिंग डायबिटीज मेलिटस इन पर्सन विद एक्टिव टीबी, रिकमेंड रिपीटिंग ग्लूकोज लेवल वीकली फॉर द फर्स्ट 4 weeks एंड देन मंथली. रीइंफोर्स लाइफस्टाइल चेंजेस एट ईच विजिट, डायटरी चेंजेस, फिजिकल एक्टिविटी, जो आप लोग बताते हैं डायबिटीज के लिए वो सब बताइए. स्ट्रिक्ट इंसुलिन यूज ड्यूरिंग द ट्रीटमेंट फॉलोड बाय स्विच ओवर टू OHA. दिस इज द रिकमेंडेशन फ्रॉम द इंटरनेशनल गाइडलाइन, नेशनल गाइडलाइन, सेंट्रल टीबी डिवीजन. एवरीबडी इज रिकमेंडिंग, इवन API इज रिकमेंडिंग, सम एवरीबडी इज रिकमेंडेड, बट इट इज ऑफकोर्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू फॉलो. मरीज को कहिए आप कल से दोली ले रहा था, आप कल से इंसुलिन लो, बड़ा दिक्कत होती है, लेकिन बट वी ट्राई टू डू दिस. Because a lot of drug interaction, especially with the rifampicin, with oral hypoglycemic, that's why we suggest that patients should be switched over to the, and even some esomeprazole and ethambutol can interact with a lot of oral hypoglycemic, and that's why we say. So definitely there is a tuberculosis and diabetes linkage, and that's why we publish a paper that is called Diabetes Mellitus with Pulmonary Tuberculosis, a double trouble. Really, it's a double trouble published in IMA Journal, which is, IMA Journal is the most highly circulated journal in India, circulated to 4 lakh doctor of IMA. And tuberculosis, what is the linkage? The patient with TB have a higher prevalence of diabetes. This is also true. Studies have shown high prevalence of impaired glucose tolerance in patient with TB. This is also true. Most TB patients have malnutrition and low body mass index. So malnutrition has been postulated as modulatory factor in the pathogenesis of diabetes. About 10% of TB cases globally are associated with diabetes. A large proportion of people with diabetes as well as TB are not diagnosed or is diagnosed too late. Early detection can help improve care and control of both diseases. Probably that's why this topic has been kept. Uncontrolled diabetes can lengthen the time to sputum culture conversion. And theoretically, this could also lead to the development of drug resistance, although this is not proven. People with diabetes who are diagnosed with TB have a higher risk of death during the TB treatment and a higher risk of TB relapse after completing treatment. So that is should be remembered. And that's why early diagnosis of pulmonary tuberculosis, early diagnosis of diabetes should be maintained and both diseases should be controlled together. Drug interaction between oral and hypoglycemic reference are established fact, and diabetes mellitus is a risk factor for hepatic toxicity with TB drugs, immune suppressive effect of diabetes. So a lot of we have to monitor by liver function monitoring. In nutshell, I would say that tuberculosis is a major health problem in our country and globally. Don't forget sputum examination, sputum for EFB and sputum for CVNet or TrueNet. Follow the treatment guidelines. All are available on website of Central TB Division, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Government of India. Persons with diabetes and TB require careful management of both diseases simultaneously. Uncontrolled diabetes adversely affect the overall treatment outcomes for persons with active TB. For optimal TB outcome, diabetes must be controlled. Referral, close coordination and care management between TB care providers and DM diabetes mellitus care providers is essential to assure the cure. And that's why a close interaction between physician and chest physician is mandatory. Thank you very much for providing this wonderful time. Thank you very much.